through and take a seat and we can get started. Okay. It's lovely to meet you. My name is Miss Lottie, and I understand that ever so slightly you have been struggling with your academic progress. But I don't want you to worry, because that's where I step in, and I'm going to give you some private tutoring sessions, and together we can help you catch up with the rest of your class. Okay, so please don't worry. I know it can be frustrating to not understand a concept or to take longer than your other friends at grasping something. I promise you that with a little bit of one-to-one help, we can make you as intelligent as the rest of your class. Okay, so for today's session, I thought we could start with doing a little bit of work on the whiteboard, learning about and then after that, we could read a story together. And then finally, we are going to work on some numbers. More specifically, counting back from 100. So today's session is starting off with the basics. Once we have fully worked on the basics together, then we can jump straight into the more advanced material. So, let me grab my whiteboard here. Now, as you can see, before this class, I wrote out every letter. Now, can you tell me how many letters there are in the English alphabet? Great, well done. So there are 26 different letters on my whiteboard. And as you can see, they are all capital letters. So what we are going to do together is fill in the blanks with the appropriate lowercase letter. Okay. So, let's start off with the letter A. Just grab my pen. Nice and simple. It looks very similar to our uppercase C, except you would draw it slightly smaller. Okay. Now moving on to D. This is how we would draw the letter D in its lowercase form. Okay. Now, it's really important that you make sure that the long part of your lowercase d is very much accentuated. Otherwise, it could look like an A and be mistaken. Okay, so make sure to create a long, long neck on your D when you're writing. Okay, next we have the letter E. Okay, E for elephant. And there is our lowercase e. Coming down to F. F for frog. And that is how we would illustrate a lowercase f. Okay, as you can see, it's smaller and slightly more curly than our moving on to G. G for grape. And there we are. That is how you would draw a G. Make sure to make the tail of your G nice and long and curly. Okay? Now, moving on to the letter H. H for hat. And that is how we would illustrate the letter H. Okay. Now let's move on to the letter I. I for a lowercase I. Then we have the letter J. So here is our uppercase J. And our lowercase J. So very similar to the I, except it has been flipped. Now, if we move on to K, K for kangaroo. And there we have a lowercase k. So, fairly similar to our uppercase, except it has a nice little curl on it. And again, it's written slightly smaller. And then we come to the letter L. L for Lottie. And there we have the lowercase L. Okay. Now let's move over to the letter M. M for mop. Lowercase m with a bit more curl. As you can see here, it goes up and comes back down as a point, but with our lowercase, it's more of a curved top. Okay, now moving on to n. N for north. And here lowercase n. Now it's quite important that you don't confuse this with our lowercase h. So when writing your h, you want to have a nice tall point there, but with the n, make sure that it's very nice and short. Otherwise, people might mistake your n's for Now moving on to the letter O. O for orange. And this one again is very nice and simple. And all you need to do for your lowercase o is a much smaller o. Okay. Now we will move on to the letter P. P for purple. And again, this is a nice simple one. You just have to do a smaller version of the uppercase P. Okay. Moving on to our letter Q. Q for queen. And the lowercase q does actually look quite different to its capital. That is how you would illustrate that one. Okay. Make sure that you can make a clear difference in appearance between your G and your Q so that people are not mistaking each letter for the other. Now, moving on to the letter R. R for rabbit. And you just draw the lowercase r, like so. So a short line, and then a curve coming off from that line. Okay. Now we're moving on to the letter S. S for south. And again, this is nice and simple for you. You simply draw a smaller version. Then next, we have the letter T. T for tiger. And you would draw the letter T like so. Okay, so a nice curve with a cross through the middle. Then we have the letter U. U for umbrella. And again, you would draw a smaller version, but with a little tail coming off from the right hand side. Moving on to V. V for violet. This one is very nice and simple. Smaller version of its capital form. Okay, now we're slowly approaching the end of our alphabet. We have got the letter W. W for west. And this is very similar to M, where you simply want to write it a little bit smaller than its capital and with curved bottoms. So I suppose the M and the W are the same, except the W is upside down. Next, we have the letter. Xylophone. And again, very nice and simple. It's just the smaller version. Okay. Now, moving on to the letter Y. Y for yellow. A lowercase g, except it space between those parts there. And finally, we have the letter Z, Z for zebra. And we can finish off the alphabet with another nice and simple lowercase. So it's just the same, but written slightly smaller. Okay, so my darling, there we have the full English alphabet. So I'm just going to leave that over here next to me. And now that we have worked on looking at the letters of the alphabet together, we can now move on to reading a story. Okay, my darling, the story that I've chosen to read to you today is a bit of a classic, and this is The Gingerbread Man. Okay? Able to read this to you, and while I'm reading it, you can just relax and enjoy looking at the fun illustrations on the front. Okay, and as you can see, this is a level 2 reading. So I'll show you the different levels. We have level 1. Is for children who are ready to take their first steps in reading. Okay, but you're better than that, so we'll be reading a level 2 book. And this is for beginner readers who can read short, simple sentences with help. And that follows on to level 3, which is for more confident readers who can read simple stories. And then finally, level 4. Longer stories for more independent, fluent readers. And my darling, I'm sure very shortly you will be part of the level 4. Because working together, we can really rapidly improve your reading skills. Okay? My darling. Okay. Once upon a time, a little old woman made a gingerbread man. She put him in the oven to cook. There we are, popping him in the oven. Soon, the gingerbread man was cooked. The little old woman took him out of the oven. The gingerbread man jumped up and ran out of the door. "Stop, little gingerbread man," shouted the little old woman. "I want to eat you for my tea." Gingerbread man would not stop. The little old woman chased the gingerbread man, but she could not catch him. soon, the gingerbread man met a cow. "Stop, little gingerbread man," shouted the cow. "I want to eat you for my tea." But the gingerbread man would not stop. The cow chased the gingerbread man, but she could not catch him. Soon, gingerbread man met a horse. "Stop, little gingerbread man," shouted the horse. "I want to eat you for my tea." But the gingerbread man chased the gingerbread man, but he could not catch him. Soon, the gingerbread man came to a river. There he met "I'll help you to cross the river," said the fox. "Jump up onto my tail." So the gingerbread man jumped onto the fox's tail. "My feet are wet," said the gingerbread man. "Jump onto the fox's back. "My feet are still wet," said the gingerbread man. "Jump up onto my head," said the fox. Oh dear. So the gingerbread man jumped onto the fox's head. And that was the end of the gingerbread man. So that is the end of the story. And hopefully soon we can move on to level 3. Really crisp and sweet and juicy. Nearly time for your nap. I want you to just sit and relax, and I'm going to count back from 100 all the way down to 0. You can join in with me if you'd like, but this exercise is purely to make you sleepy for your nap while also learning how to come back from 100. Okay. So if you would just like to lie there.
Sixty.